In this video, we are going to apply the concept of derivatives to solve a real-life situation. Let's consider a scenario where we have a water tank positioned on a support structure with height h. Let's say the water level in the tank is L. Now, a practical question arises. What is the value of x here, where x is the distance from the top surface of the water to the hole, such that when the hole is created, the water exiting from it will travel the farthest possible horizontal distance, r. Okay, I will rephrase the problem. We need to compute the value of x such that r yields a maximum value. Okay, the horizontal distance traveled by the water, which is represented by r, is equal to its horizontal velocity multiplied by the time it takes to travel from the hole to the ground. Now, the horizontal velocity of the water is equal to its exit velocity. Now, the exit velocity of the water is equal to the square root of 2gh, where g is the acceleration due to gravity and h is the height of the column of the fluid above the opening. So, this h here is equal to x. So we can rewrite the formula for the horizontal velocity as the square root of 2gx. Okay, let's take note that the horizontal velocity of the water is constant. The moment the water comes out from the hole until it lands on the ground, its velocity remains constant, and it is always equal to the square root of 2gx. Now, this might raise the question of why the horizontal velocity of the water is unaffected by gravity. The reason is that gravity acts solely in the vertical downward direction and does not exert any influence on the horizontal motion of the water. So the next issue that we need to address is time. So time is equal to the square root of 2d over g. G is again the acceleration due to gravity, and d represents this distance, the height of the hole from the ground. Now we know that this distance here is x, and the level of water is L, and the height of the structure is h. Therefore, d can be calculated geometrically as h plus L minus x. So we can write the formula for time as the square root of 2 multiplied by the quantity h plus L minus x all over g. And then we can rewrite r as the square root of 2gx times the square root of two h plus l minus x over g. And then we can bring these two terms together under a single radical sign, so we obtain the following. Then we can cancel out the g. 2 times 2 is 2 squared, and the expression left inside the radical sign is h plus l minus x multiplied by x. And then we can distribute x inside the radical sign and we get the following. It's plus L x minus x squared. And then we can further rewrite the right hand side by using the exponentiation form instead of the radical sign. So we get the following. Okay, so this is the formula for the horizontal distance traveled by the water. And in order to obtain the value of x such that r will yield the maximum value, we need to differentiate r with respect to x. Okay, so first let's write down the constant, and then we need to apply the power rule to differentiate this expression here. So the exponent is 1/2, the inside function is x plus l x minus x squared. So this is the inside function, and then we subtract 1 from the exponent, so 1/2 minus 1 is negative 1/2, and then we multiply the result by the derivative of the inside function. So the derivative of this term or expression is x plus l, and then the derivative of negative x squared is negative 2x. And then simplifying, we can cancel out 2 here, so the derivative of r with respect to x is equal to, first we write down this expression in the numerator, so it's plus l minus 2x. And then since this quantity is having a negative exponent, we can also bring it down. So it's plus l x minus x squared, and then make the exponent positive. Okay, so this is the derivative of r with respect to x. And then what is the next step? The next step is to set the derivative of r with respect to x equal to 0. So 0 equals x plus l minus 2x over x plus l x minus x squared to the power 1/2. Now, multiplying both sides of the equation by this quantity here, we get 0 equals x plus l minus 2x. And solving for x, we get x plus l over 2. So this is the value of x that will make the value of r yield the maximum value. Now, let's substitute this value into the formula for r. So r is equal to the square root of x plus l x minus x squared. Now let's substitute this value of x. So 2 multiplied by x plus l, the value of x is x plus l over 2 minus x plus l over 2 squared. R equals 2, so x plus l multiplied by x plus l is x plus l squared over 2 minus x plus l squared over 4. So this is 1/2 and 1/4 of x plus l squared. So if we simplify that, we get x plus l squared over 4. And then extracting the square root, we obtain the following: x plus l over 2, and then canceling 2. We finally obtain the maximum value of R, H plus L. So this is the maximum value of R. Okay, now I will explain why we need to differentiate the function and set the derivative equal to zero. Okay, first let me draw the graph of R versus X. So this is R and this is the x-axis, this is the r-axis. Now the graph of the function of R with respect to X will look like this. Okay, this is not a perfect curve, but you got the idea. Okay, now let's locate the highest point on the graph. So here is the highest point, and let the coordinate values for this point be xm comma rm. So this is xm, and this is rm. Now the problem we are actually solving is finding these coordinate values. Now in order to determine the coordinate values of the highest point on the graph, the concept of derivatives provides us with the method to solve it. We must remember that the derivative of a function refers to the slope of the tangent line at any point on the graph. And additionally, we know that at the highest point, the slope of the tangent line is zero, as it is parallel to the horizontal axis. So this is why we need to differentiate the function and set its derivative equal to zero in order to obtain the coordinates of the highest point on the graph. So this approach enables us to effectively solve optimization problems of this kind.
Based on the data provided, the support structure has a height of 3 feet, while the water level in the tank is 9 feet. Additionally, you have chosen a hole distance of 4 feet. Consequently, the hole's height from the ground is 8 feet. The acceleration due to gravity is 32.16 feet per second squared, leading to a horizontal velocity of 16.04 feet per second. The time the water takes to travel from the hole to the ground is 0.705 seconds. According to the chosen hole distance, x, the water will cover a horizontal distance of 11.308 feet. However, the hole distance that would make the water travel the farthest horizontal distance is 6 feet, while the farthest horizontal distance is 12 feet. Based on the data provided, the support structure has a height of 5 feet. while the water level in the tank is 12 feet. Additionally, you have chosen a hole distance of 3 feet. Consequently, the hole's height from the ground is 14 feet. The acceleration due to gravity is 32.16 feet per second squared, leading to a horizontal velocity of 13.891 feet per second. The time the water takes to travel from the hole to the ground is 0.933 seconds. According to the chosen hole distance, x, the water will cover a horizontal distance of 12.96 feet. However, the hole distance that would make the water travel the farthest horizontal distance is 8.5 feet, while the farthest horizontal distance is 17 feet.